Suppose I asked you this question. How many ways can a group of three people be chosen for a committee from a group of 10 people? At first, this kind of has the ring of the permutations that we've talked about so far. But what makes this different from a permutation is that there's nothing special about being selected first versus being selected third. For example, here, these three groups, Anne, Ben, and Charles, versus Ben, Charles, and Anne, versus Charles, Ben, and Anne, all of these groups represent the same committee, even though the names were in a different order. Right now, if these were permutations, we would have to consider each of them to be different. But for purposes of committee selection, all that matters is that they were chosen, not the order in which they are chosen. This kind of arrangement, where the order of the items in the list doesn't matter, is what we call a combination. And the definition, the exact definition is here on the screen. A combination is an unordered arrangement of the objects in a set. And a combination with R elements is called an R combination. Just like, you know, a permutation of R elements was called an R permutation. Now, on this slide, I put the definition of a combination and a permutation side by side so we can compare them. And you notice that there's only one word difference between the two. This is a great example of why it's important to learn mathematical definitions exactly. Changing one word, for example, ordered versus unordered, can have a dramatic change in what the definition means. Now, when they're given a specific problem to solve, students often run into challenges deciding whether the problem is an example of a permutation or whether it's an example of a combination. So I want to take a little time here and discuss how I go about distinguishing the two. Now, the way I approach the question of what type of problem I'm looking at goes like this. I pick a specific example of the situation, a specific selection, a specific choice, and then I change the order of it and see if the results are different. For example, let's look at these two scenarios here. In example one, we're choosing two people to go on a free cruise vacation. In example two, we're also choosing two people to be president and vice president. Now, compare Alice and Ben to Ben and Alice in both of those situations. All right? In example one, Alice comma Ben means this one here, Alice comma Ben, means both Alice and Ben go on the vacation. And if we reverse their order, if we switch them, Ben comma Alice means Ben and Alice go on the vacation. Now go over and look at example two and let's see what happens when we do the same thing. In this case, Alice comma Ben means Alice is president and Ben is vice president. Where down here, if we flip them, Ben comma Alice means Ben is president and Alice is vice president. So what can we conclude based on those results? And this is kind of the key point here. In the first scenario, the two examples both mean the same thing. In both cases, Ben and Alice go on the vacation. Because both arrangements of the names give you the same result, that makes this an example of a combination, where the order doesn't matter. Now, in the second example, the first arrangement has Alice as the president, where the second arrangement has Ben as the president. In this case, because changing the order gave us a different result, this would be an example of a permutation.